Theological Deliberations on the Meaning of Life, Bain's The Wondrous Art of Nature. It is at best an ongoing project, as I was reminded of the people who are not driving but walking on rough roads. Women plowing fields, vendors desperately trying to sell their products, while others collect and select their products to be wheeled as rations stored for the year. Washing at village water bodies, woodworking, weaving intricate designs on traditional attire. Do they carve their personal meaning to life? Or they just labor from day to day to make both ends meet? For most, the sky is the limit to enable them to feed their families and survive. Adaptability and survival instincts are personal and varied. Eat, enjoy, sleep would apply to most of the people in the world. Survival depends on faith. We accept medical aid for faith in its curative effects. We look to seniors for guidance because of our trust in their experiences. We believe that unseen supernaturalism empowers us to survive and champion any challenges. If we have faith as small as a grain to survive, it is bound to germinate and prosper. In the end, the meaning of life is dependent on individual schools of thought, filled with hope, aim, and ambition to succeed, and how well we balance it, as they are footings of our decisions, businesses, happiness, daily needs, spirituality, faith, empathy, friendship, freedom, family. These thoughts carried me far away and brought me to ground level, as there is little reason for arrogance about the simple meaning of life. Given the poor state of the world and mankind, there exists people whose happiness includes the pursuit of happiness of others, the joy of gifting, compassion, sharing, laughter, passion, and the determination to succeed. Worthy of mention is a Khasi Gama girl, Claudia Jessica Bamon.
Hi, I'm Claudia Jessica Bowman, and I'm a professional fitness athlete. It started just, fitness for me. And then I felt like I could do something because I always wanted to represent my state, represent India in some form. In 2016, Mr. Meghalaya hosted a Best Physique event for women. So I took the opportunity, I grabbed it, and then from there on, I started as a professional bodybuilder. As you know, it's a male-dominant, category where only males are portrayed there. I was the first female from Meghalaya to ever step on stage. We have so many categories in bodybuilding for women. We have a bikini, we have a physique, we have sports physique, we have model physique. I am successful because I love myself. I want myself to be the better version what I was yesterday. My future plan is to win the World Physique Championship. Just to be in the gym, that is not it. You have to have good nutrition, you have to get good balanced diet. So for that we need money. And for me it was not easy because I was doing my master's daytime. And night time is the only time that I'm free. So I took on the bouncer job. And from the state, as now, no.
No finances coming in?
No, I have, I've given applications, but still there's no response. I'm so happy that I have inspired many women. It's all in the mind. You should not look at someone, based on their caste, on their creed, on whatever it is. Just look at them as a human being. You might not know what the person might be, become also. So if you can inspire someone, please do inspire someone. If you can help them in any way, please help them. And might not know where it will lead them. And you'll be proud of yourself.
Claudia was inducted into MSGF on the 16th of November 2019. From a humble beginning, today she is the proud owner of Claudia Fitness Hub, launched on 31st of December 2019. In her routine, she slots a timing in the morning to impart free training to aspiring athletes of the underprivileged section of the society to harness their dream. Today, Claudia remains true to her promise to serve God, society, and country.